We want to continue to talk about big tech with our guest host, Alan Patricof, co-founder and managing director of venture capital firm Greycroft. Your sense on all of this? I mean, is there a monopoly out there?
I'm totally supportive of this investigation. I think they're going to find that they have been monopolistic in terms of acquiring companies. They have crowded the market.
I want you to go back to this idea of been monopolistic in terms of acquiring companies.
And by the way, I sell them some of the companies, so right. I'm talking against myself.
But explain this to me. At the time that, for example, Facebook bought Instagram for $1 billion, some people thought it was crazy. I mean, truly crazy town, right? Didn't make any, I mean, people thought they were overpaying. How could you, and by the way, of course, it's now turned into a success, but you got to have a real crystal ball to make that
Say the same case. Thing for WhatsApp. I think that what's happened is I honestly don't think they started out to become monopolists. I mean, we're not going back to the robber baron days of the early 1900s when the railroads bought companies to own every bit of the network so you'd have to pay higher prices. The same with the oil business where they wanted to grab every oil well. I think these are companies that have grown organically, but they've just gotten so big now that they have frightened off other people. And the result, in the case of, for example, Amazon, has resulted in lower prices, which is totally anachronistic to the concept of monopoly. But I think we have to face the reality that, for example, I know for our firm, and I know for many other firms, no one wants to touch new media companies. No one wants to touch companies who are dependent upon advertising because these other fangs have sucked up the market.
Is your answer to break these companies up, or is your answer to not let them make future acquisitions? Is your answer to monitor them? What are you trying to do here?
I don't have the answer, but I think to a certain extent they have to be regulated more than they've been, and it may be in the end. The problem is they collect the data from all these other companies that they mm-hmm. acquire, and with that data, they probably know whoever they are, that we're sitting here right now. I don't know if they know what we're talking about, but they know where we are. Mm-hmm. They know where we're going. They know what we eat. They know what our medical problems are. And I think it's dangerous long term for having a limited number of companies have this amount of data and then be able to capitalize upon it in terms of selling advertising primarily. And it's very tough to compete with if you're a smaller company.